Greetings, my Hebrew Israelite brothers and sisters. This is L.D. Smith, the Watchman on the Wall. As always, grab that King James. First and foremost, before we get started, I want to let everyone know that our job here at lightofmenomore.org is to instruct the people and to warn the people about what is going to transpire in our near future. And we here, lightofmenomore.org, we are not going any place. All right, we are like the fibers that are in a piece of fabric. There are many strands, but it is one solid piece. Putting it more in a more simpler way is that we are a nation of people. We are a family. We are the true Hebrew Israelites. We are the people of God. We are the only holy people that are on this planet. All right? And that being said, let me back that up. Now, let's go to the book of Ezekiel real quick. Ezekiel 33. And let's look at verses 3. Starting with verses 3, and we're going to read up to verses 7. All right? Just to let you know that we can't go anywhere. Even if we want to go somewhere, we can't, all right? Now, that being said, it says in verse 3, it says, if when he seeth, the sword cometh upon the land, he bloweth the trumpet and warn the people. Then whosoever heareth the sound of the trumpet and taketh not warning, if the sword come and take him away, his blood shall be upon his own hands. He heareth the sound of the trumpet, verse 5, and take not warning, his blood shall be upon him. But he that taketh warning shall deliver his soul. But if the watchman, talking about we here at lightofmenomore.org, all right, I'm the watchman, he says, if the watchman see the sword come and blow not the trumpet, know what he says, and the people be not warned, if the sword come and take any persons from among them, he is taken away in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at the watchman's hand. See that? I'm not going to be in trouble with God in no way, shape, or form or fashion. So I'm not going anywhere. Don't you ever worry. I am here throughout the duration, all right? We're not going any place here Lie to Me No More, all right? Now, let us finish up here. It says in verse 7, it says, so thou son of man, I have set thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore thou shalt hear the word at my mouth and warn them for me. All right? So, my sister, we're not going any place. All right? My brothers, we're not going any place. We're here to stay. Now, that being said, let's move a little further here. Let's go to the book of Jeremiah, the 30th chapter, and let's go there real quick, because we're going to show you here tonight that our day is coming, and we just have to wait. You know, they're marching now because of our brother's blood cries from the sewer drain, because they sprayed the street off and washed his blood down the sewer drain, but Yah sees it, and he is hearing to our cry right now. So grab that King James, and let us open up our minds, and let us look at the word of Yah, all right? Let us look at Jeremiah chapter 30. We're going to start with verse 3. It says, for lo, the day is cometh, saith the Lord, that I will bring again the captivity of my people Israel and Judah, saith the Lord, and I will cause them. Know what he says. I will cause them. Now, those people that are over there in our land now, they went back on wings of eagle. God didn't call them to go, but he says when the time comes, he's going to cause us to go back. So those are the fake ones over there. Let's go forward here. Look what he says now. He says, I will call them. Here in verse 3, he says, the captivity of Israel and Judah, said the Lord, and I will cause them to return to the land that I gave their fathers, and they shall possess it. And these are the words that the Lord spake concerning Israel and concerning Judah. For thus saith the Lord, we have heard the voice of trembling and of fear, and not of peace. That's right now. As ye know, and see whether a man do travail with child. Wherefore I do see every man with his hands on his loins, as a woman in travail, and all faces are turned into plainness. Nobody says here in verse 7, he says, alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble. Now we are Jacob's seed, talking about us. He said, but he shall be saved out of it. See, Yah is giving an illustration of when he coming back to get us out of this hell hole. When he's going to come back and gather his children from all the nations around the world, and he's going to take us back home. Note what he says here. He says in verse 8, he says, for it shall come to pass in that day, saith the Lord of hosts, that I will break his yoke from off of thy neck. See that? Y'all saying that when he come back, he gonna break the yoke off of our neck. See, we are still slaves. We still got a yoke around our neck. Right now, the same way we came over here in chains that you could see. They got us still in chains in technology. My brothers and sisters, you have to see it for what it is. You want to be like them, but we are nothing like them. Nothing. Now, look what he says here. See, deliverance is on the way, but they can march all they want to it. They ain't got nothing coming. They're wasting their time. The only one that is going to break the chains off of us is Yah when he comes back. They can march all day long. Anyone that knows anything about going into battle, you march to go into battle. You don't march to go into peace. They having a peaceful protest, marching for peace. I mean, how stupid can one be? You march when you're going into battle, not when you're going in a peaceful fashion, if I may say. Now look what he says here. He says, break from off of thy neck, and will bust their bands, and strangers shall no more serve themselves over him. In other words, these white folks ain't gonna have no more power over us, y'all. They're not going to have any more power and control over us when he comes back. He's going to change this thing. But we can't change it. You can march all day long. You ain't going to get no verdict. You waste your time. You're not going to get no guilty verdict. You're just wasting your time. Wasting money and wasting of all this time y'all are marching up and down the street acting like fools and the man just doing whatever he want to do to you. You're just wasting your time. It's right here. You're not going to get anything until Yah comes back. Now it's time for Israel to turn to their black God and leave this white motherfucker alone. Israel, it's time to wake up. Come on. Look what he says here. In verse 9, he says, but they shall serve the Lord their God and David their king, whom I will raise up unto them. Now y'all know David is dead. Y'all know King David is dead. But y'all saying that I'm going to raise, after he break the bands from around our neck, and after he take the yokes from off our necks and all these chains off us through electronics, he says then he's going to put us back in our land, and David is going to be our king. Now, to reassure that, let us go a little further here. Let us look at verse 10. It said, therefore, fear thou not, O my servant Jacob, said the Lord, neither be dismayed, O Israel, for lo, I will save thee from afar, and thy seed from the land of their captivity, and Jacob shall return, and shall be in rest, and be quiet, and none shall make him afraid. Now, if those are the people that are over there in Israel, why are they fighting right now? Why are they fighting against the Palestinians? Why are they fighting against the Egyptians? I mean, clearly, the Bible proves them wrong right here. They are not the true people. We are. Now, look at verse 11. 11 says, for I am with thee, saith the Lord, to save thee. Though I make a full end of all nations, whether I have scattered thee, yet will I not make a full end of thee, but I will correct thee in measure, and I will not leave thee altogether unpunished. God saying he gonna punish us for our disobedience and our sins. Now, that being said, let's look at King David here. Let's go to the book of Amos real quick. Amos the 9th chapter. We're going to look at verse 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Look at what it says here. In that day I will raise up the tabernacle of David that has fallen. Talking about past tense. If something has fallen, that's past. All right. David is dead. Now look what he says. And close up the breach thereof, and I will raise up his ruins. He's going to raise up King David's dead body. My sisters and brothers, can you see that? Next time someone come to you telling you any damn thing about Jesus, you show them the scripture here and ask them to explain it to you. Tell them, well, explain Amos 9, chapter 9, verse 11 to me. Ask them and seek it to explain it to you. But I'm going to explain it to you. Look what it says here. He says, the breach thereof, and I will raise up his ruins, and I will build it as it was in the days of old. Now, was Jesus back there over Israel in the days of old? Hell no! It was David. Jesus wasn't even born then. Look at verse 12. It says, that they may possess the remnant of Edom and of all the heathens which are called by my name, saith the Lord that doeth this. In other words, all them that's over there calling themselves Israelites. They call themselves Israelis, but they want to say that they're Israelites. Not true. We are the true people. Now look what he says here. He says, behold, the day cometh, saith the Lord, that the plowman shall overtake the reapers. In other words, the one that's over there reaping all the benefits, reaping all the goods. Over here, we ain't getting shit. We are slaves. He said, we're going to overtake them. He says that the plowman shall overtake the reapers and the treaders of the grapes, him that soweth seed, and the mountain shall drop sweet wine, and all the hills shall melt. And I will bring again the captivity of my people Israel, and they, know what it says here, and they shall build the wasted cities and inhabit them. And they shall plant vineyards and drink the wine thereof. They shall also make gardens and eat the fruit of them. And I will plant them upon their land, and they shall no more be pulled up out of their land, which I have given them, said the Lord thy God. Now, if that's the case, why are they fighting over there? If there are two people, why are they fighting over there? I mean, my sisters and brothers, it's right here before us. We have to see it for whatever it is. Now, let me reiterate something here. We hear a lot of minimal.org. We going all the way. We can't leave. I showed you what he showed us in Ezekiel. Now, to show you something a little more, let's say that we wanted to stop. Where could we go? Where could we go that he would not come and get us? Where could we go and hide from the all-powerful, almighty God? Where could we go? Let's go to 2 Chronicles. Let's go to real quick. See, you have to see it. That's why I asked you. Let any of them say anything they want to, but don't listen to them. Tell them to prove it to you. Because I back up everything that I say. 2 Chronicles chapter 6. Verses 17, 18. Now, Solomon here is talking with Yah about the promise that he made to his father David. He said, now then, O Lord God of Israel, let thy word be verified, which thou hast spoken unto thy servant David. But will God in very deed dwell with men on earth? Behold, heaven and the heaven of heaven cannot contain thee, how much less this house which I have built. See that? Anywhere to go. The heavens and above the heavens of the heavens cannot contain him. I refuse to make God man. My brothers and sisters, until next time, shalom.